4 days into the new year, and maybe some of us have let our resolutions slip a little. Has anyone let their resolutions slip?
Yeah, I've been to the gym once. And I'm not going to go.
It's day four.
Yeah.
But failure doesn't have to be all bad. Can we really learn from it? That's our daily dilemma today. And let's welcome social commentator John Caldwell. John, good morning.
Good morning.
Now, we love making the New Year's resolutions.
We do. Even the people that say they don't actually do still make them secretly.
But we break them just as easily.
92% of people break their New Year's resolutions, and most of them within the first week, a.k.a. everybody.
That's me. Guilty. Guilty as charged.
Yeah. It's pretty... I think a lot of people... This year, I've heard a lot of people saying, oh, I didn't make any New Year's resolutions. I just had this chat with a gorgeous lady in makeup. She goes, I didn't make any. I said, oh, OK, you might not have called it a resolution, but did you say, this year I'm going to... She goes, oh, yeah, I did that. I was going to travel some more this year. So everybody does it, even if we don't think we do. So why do we break it? I think because... I think we get confused about the goal versus the activity. So we say, I want to lose weight. Well, a week in, you haven't gone to the gym once, you think, oh, bugger it, I've failed on that, I'll wait till next year now. I think what we should be doing is saying, I'm going to exercise for 30 minutes a day as my resolution. Oh, I didn't do it on Monday, I've still got Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So break it down into smaller chunks.
So if you fall off the wagon, keep going. Don't be disillusioned and say, OK, 364 more days till I have to.
I mean, it's a pretty tough thing. You've got to think about it. If you've already got a challenge with food in your life, and you use that to hide other things, and then suddenly you say, I'm going to give up eating or I'm going to exercise more or lose weight. When you fail, what's the number one thing you're going to do? You're going to end up eating more than you did in the first place. So you've really got to be careful about these resolutions, not upsetting your psycho too much.
I made more affirmations this year.
What were they?
Yes. Like, I had them on my Facebook, as you do with all your Facebook things, and they were things like dream big, be grateful, give love.
You said give love when you looked at me.
I feel it. And I said dance in the sun, be your own person and eat strawberries. Although I think I should eat watermelon. Now I've learnt all the healing properties.
Any reason for strawberries, Jo?
Well, I just thought strawberries are the one fruit you don't really... They're not apples, oranges. They're just sort of a little... delicacy.
Oh, treat yourself. That's just the nicest thing I've ever heard. I know. I mean, you are such a sweet thing.
Sure, it's not all negative as well, because I do think there's positives to it as well. Like, if setting those smaller goals, you'll feel better when you achieve some of them. So I think just to say throw out New Year's resolution is not the right answer. But because I think it does make us feel better when we do it sometimes.
My resolution is to be bold and beautiful with you, Robert.
I better start practicing.
Well, I can feel a segment coming on.
I can feel something coming on. Ida, I'm ready.
Thank you so much for joining us. Much appreciated.